There are a number of migration hotspots along the north shore of Lake Erie in Ontario. One of those is Long Point Provincial Park. In this unprecedented year, nearly all of these locations were closed for the vast majority of migration season. However, the provincial parks began to open up just at the very end of migration, giving one last opportunity to observe hundreds to thousands of migrating birds passing through on their journey north. Normally, Long Point would be packed with birders, but on this day in this spring of solitude, I could count on one hand the number of visitors to this important migration flyway. My name is Rob, and this is Songbirding.
So I'm at Long Point Provincial Park, and I've got chipping sparrow and yellow warbler. So we've got a brown thrasher here. This is a mimic. A lot like mockingbirds in terms of how they act with vocalizations. Bigger than a mockingbird and brown. Seem to have two modes, being completely inconspicuous and being completely obvious. Telling mockingbird and brown thrasher apart by ear takes a while to get to understand the nuances of the difference between them. Might not even be possible outside of certain regions though too. For us, mockingbird is a year-round bird, doesn't really migrate, but brown thrashers do migrate. They are not really here in the winter. Once in a while there's a stray one in the winter, but that's about it. I personally find the brown thrasher holds on to its mimicry a little more, as in a mockingbird might go through several different bird species in a quicker pace, quicker tempo than the brown thrasher does. Brown thrasher is a little slower, a bit more gap between each bout of mimicry. This thrasher is high up in a tree. They might stay low down sometimes and sing. They don't seem to mind people too much, I find. Bird could be on territory. Because they do like this kind of meadow setting that we're in right now, kind of parkland meadow right now. A lot of shrubs around to hide in and some tall trees to sing from. All right. and head towards the beach, see what we have here. Now we're in a sandy meadow. Kind of environment I haven't really recorded in much. We've got some northern perula here. Lots of yellow warblers. Some might be here because they're on territory. Quite a few of them will be here because of migration. As you can hear, quite close to the beach now. Quite a lot of yellow warblers here, everywhere I look. A couple kingbirds. Of course, there's some residents here like chickadees and northern cardinal. They're just here year round. Couple warbling vireos here as well. As you can hear, it's a lot of sweet, sweet, sweeter than sweet songs. All yellow warblers.
Songbirding, Spring of Solitude was recorded, engineered, narrated, and created by me, Rob Porter, with Creative Commons music from Kai Engel. Thank you for listening to this third season of Songbirding. A new season of episodes will start soon in the new year, which will focus on bird species recorded on their breeding territories. You can help spread the word about the show by rating and reviewing on Apple Podcasts, or on podchaser.com/songbirding. You can also help support the show on patreon.com/songbirding.